Hey guys, it's Monica at Academic Phoenix Plus, and welcome to the second part of this video tutorial where we texture a book, a leather book with gold trimming. In the last video tutorial, we textured the book with leather, we added some gold decorations, and in this video, we are going to create the pages and then export the textures to bring it into Maya. Before I forget, don't forget that you can download this model for free at academicphoenixplus.com. You can find the book and follow along. So take a look at academicphoenixplus.com. All right, let's go ahead and finish texturing this leather book. All right, let's talk about the pages. So the pages are specifically located right here, and I know the list is a little weird. Let me go back to default. So again, you can go over here and just type in shape. And I'll just make it smaller so it doesn't look like it's going to make a giant mess. All right, so here we are. It's time to make some pages. So I'm going to choose another material. Now, unfortunately, if I type in here, there is no paper, there is no pages. So, you know, we have to use the materials that we have to, you know, be creative and create some paper. So I'm going to choose wood. And in here we have multiple shaders, and one of them is called wood rough. So I'm going to bring it to the top. And it does look like wood. So what I want to do is actually make this really skinny so that it looks like pages. So I'm going to grab this and I can scale it really skinny like that. And I can move this around. Now I can also do this here under scale. Now right now, usually this is locked, but because I grabbed it, it unlocked it. So you're more than welcome to use either or. But oops, I better move this back like this. There we go. And maybe make this longer. So again, I'm trying to use the wood, and if I crush it, I can get this really nice looking paper. Now it looks great on this side, not so hot here. So I'll show you how to fix that, but let's work on just making this look good. I'm going to scroll down, and here's the color. Let's go ahead and change this to a type of color, maybe a little bit like this. Looks okay. And I'm also going to be using a mask, because the reality is that I only need to see this paper here along the edges. So I'm going to right click, create a black mask. And this time, instead of trying to paint it in with black and white, I'm going to show you a different way to make a selection, which is UVs. Or here to the left under the brush, we have this little selection here. And you'll notice that it's got this, which means that it's going to select a face. So if I select it, it's going to select the face, which is nice because it automatically fills it with white, because this is what we have right here. So now I can click on these faces and I'm going to skip this one. Well, I can just kind of show you what it looks like right now. And then I'll just go ahead and click on these guys. There we go. You can also select it here, by the way. If you want to, you can select it here. If you accidentally select something, like as you can see, this is, I clicked and drag, and now the wood's on the top and bottom, which is not what I want. I'll just change this to black, and I can select the UVs as well. So just kind of keep an eye at it, an eye on it to make sure that it doesn't do anything crazy. Now, unfortunately, this is something that's happening with the UVs. They're stretched out, so the UVs are not laid out exactly right. So you're going to have to ignore this portion right here. So UVs are really important, as you can see just by this. If you feel like these pages are not looking great, you can always go back to the color, change this to a different color. So for example, maybe you want it to be a little whiter, maybe you want it to be a little grayer. You can make them look like they're old by changing it to a little bit more brown. So it really is pretty powerful stuff. Now, what about this area here? This isn't going to help us very much. This paper looks, it's going up and down. Well, again, that's a UVs. As you'll notice that the texture goes left to right and the UVs are going up and down. So we actually need to change this texture so that it fits in this particular UV space. So I'm going to duplicate this wood, and I'm going to stop calling it wood and calling it paper. And I click on the eyeball to reveal it and hide it. And I'm going to right click on it and I'm going to say duplicate layer. So now I have a duplicated layer. I'm going to go to the color and I want to rotate it. So I'm going to scroll up. We have rotation right here. And as you can see, it can rotate it until this is 90 degrees. So let's go ahead and change this to 90. I'm going to just physically type it in. So now this looks good, but the side doesn't look so hot. So what do we do? Well, I just want this area to be revealed. So I'm going to grab the mask. I'm going to grab the tool that I had before, which selects things by UVs. And I'm going to make sure it's in the color black, because black means you can't see it. I'm going to make a selection here. And just going to kind of look at this. And I like the fact that the UVs are moving this way. And there we go. All right. Looks good. And that is how you texture a book using Substance. Just Substance. All right, now we're ready to export this into Maya. First thing I like to do is go up here to the top right. You see how it says Lambert 3SG? Let's click on this and call it texture. Let's go to File, Export Textures. Over here, it's gonna tell me where it's gonna export. I already have a folder, so let's click on here and choose our folder. So this is my project. I am gonna go to Source Images, and I personally like to create a folder called Substance. And then in here, I'm just going to select a folder. I'm okay with PNGs, but if you guys wanted to change it to, let's say, Targas or TIFF, this would be the way to do it. But PNGs are fine with me. We can always go to the output templates, and I'm going to choose Arnold AI Standard Surface. This looks pretty good to me. Going back to settings, we're going to have base color. We have roughness, metallic, normal height, and emissive. I don't really need emissive, so I'm going to turn that off and then export. It's going to do its thing. Looks like it's done, and we're ready to go back into Maya. This is what Substance has exported for us. This is our base color. This is our height, metallic, normal, roughness. Looks cool. Okay, how do we put this all back into Maya? Well, we told Substance that this is a PBR. We're going to use the Arnold AI Standard Surface. So right-click on your model, assign a new material. I'm going to click on Arnold and choose AI Standard Surface. I'm going to call this my book shader. The first thing we're going to tackle is the base color. So go to color, click on this little output, go to file, go to that little folder, go to your substance folder and choose base color. And if you don't see anything, press the number 6 on your keyboard. All right, let's see what it looks like rendered. Now I'm just going to compare as we start putting in the map. So this is what it looks like with just a Lambert shader. And this is what it's going to look like when we just have the base color. Cool. All right, that took about 13 seconds. I'm going to be pausing so you guys don't have to watch the render. Let me take a snapshot by clicking on this little camera. Cool. Before, after. All right, let's start attaching the other things. I'm going to grab the book. We also have metalness because the gold is considered metal. So let's go to metalness. Click on this little output. Click on file. Click on this little folder, and we're going to choose metal, metallic. Now, you may think that you're done, but you need to change your color space to raw. Let's see what that looks like. Doesn't look that great. My leather is still being impacted, and my gold is right here, so there should be a difference. So what I need to click on is, if I scroll down, let's go to color balance. Keep scrolling down, and you want to choose alpha is luminance. It just means that it's going to double check on the texture, and it's going to choose black and white as visible and not visible. So let's see what that looks like. Also, let's click on this guy right here and click and drag. This will only render this area here, and I don't have to worry about the rest of it. So let's see what that looks like. Much better. It only took 3 seconds to render, but you can see the difference between here and here. All right, let's move on to the next one. Click on this little connection right here, which will take you back to the book shader. And we also have roughness. Let's go to roughness, click on this connection, file, scroll up a little bit, folder, and let's grab the roughness. Let me take a screenshot before I forget. Again, I like to change this to raw, and then change this to alpha is luminance, and let's see what that looks like. All right, let's compare before. Everything was really glossy. Now you can see that the leather is looking more leathery and the metallic stays metallic. So that's really nice. We can see the comparison. Cool. All right, let's move back here. Click on this little guy right here. We're going to scroll down. There's one more map we want to attach, which is the bump map. Well, it's actually a normal map. So it says bump mapping here. Click on this connection. Again, go to file. This is the bump 2D node. I'm going to change this bump to tangent space normal. This is how it's going to read the normal map. I also need to go into Arnold and turn off flip R. You have to tell the renderer what these channels are going to do. So just tell it to turn off flip R. Click on this connection right here under bump value. Let's scroll up a little bit, go to that folder, and let's go to substance. Pick on that normal map. Looks crazy, but that's what a normal map looks like. And same story, make sure you're in raw. Well, it automatically turns onto alpha is luminance, and let's see what that looks like. And there you go, we have our book. So you can see that before the texture was very flat, and now it's starting to look a lot nicer. Let me get a perspective view so we can take a look at it a little bit closer. Let me press the letter F just to focus and see what that looks like. I'm gonna go over here to perspective shape and let's see what that looks like. And there you go. You can see where the gold is located. You can see that it's sinking. You can see that the leather has its nice texture. You have our pages is looking really nice. And that is how you take a model from Maya, texture it in Substance, and bring the textures back into Maya to render. Let me try to get a better image here. Actually, kind of like this one. And I increased the intensity of the light so I can get a brighter render. So hopefully you guys found that helpful. Let me know by leaving a comment below. Hopefully you got a tip or two on how to texture using Maya as well as Substance Painter. By the way, you can download this book model at academicphoenixplus.com. So you can download this book for free and you can follow along. Also, don't forget to like and subscribe. That is your message to me, letting me know that you like these videos and that you want to see more. So please like, subscribe, and share. If you think a friend of yours or another 3D artist could find this helpful, please share my videos. That would be amazing. And don't forget to tag me on your social media. You can find me on Twitter, Instagram, Facebook. I would love to see your art, especially if my video tutorial somehow helped you become a stronger artist. So please tag me. I would love to see your work. So again, thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate it. Keep creating, and I will see you next time.